Hello everyone, let us discuss about the emergency contraception or EC. It is also known as post-coital contraception. Here, the pregnancy is prevented by any contraceptive measure which is taken after unsafe coitus. Broadly, it is effective in 99% of cases. In these cases, hormonal or non-hormonal preparations are used within 72 hours after coitus to prevent the pregnancy. Thus, unwanted pregnancy and its complications are avoided. One more terminology is used in these cases, that is morning after pills, means e-pills. Instead of contraception, interception is a better term as it prevents conception if the coitus was around the ovulation time. The risk of pregnancy around ovulation with single act of coitus is 8%. It reduces to 1% with the use of progesterone only pills, and with the use of COC, it reduces to 2%. COC means combined oral contraceptive. What is the need of this emergency contraception? The commonest reasons for unwanted pregnancy is failure of contraception, and the second reason is unexpected coitus. Maternal mortality due to complications of unsafe abortions is too much. It is 70,000 out of 580,000 of abortions. The risk of death due to contraceptive is comparatively less than MTP or regular childbirth. The purpose of these emergency contraception is to reduce the morbidity and mortality due to unsafe abortions and to provide a backup for contraception. The main purpose is to motivate the couple to practice the regular contraception method. Probable mode of action of emergency contraception is, one and the commonest one is, it delays or prevents the ovulation if the medicine is taken prior to ovulation. If the medicine is taken after the ovulation, then this mode of action will not be there. It alters the tubal motility, and thus transport of the sperm and ovum is prevented from fertilization. It prevents implantation by causing atrophy and sloughing of the endometrium. It causes luteolysis, thus hormonal support to the endometrium is lost. Indications of emergency contraception: condom leakage or rupture or diaphragm displacement, occasional or unplanned intercourse, and no contraception used. Patients with sexual assault or raped victims, exposure to teratogens like cytotoxic drugs, live vaccines, poisoning. Patients with recent history of expelled copper tea. And also, it can be used as a backup method if sexual contact has occurred with patients of using mini pills. In these cases, if the consumption of pills is late by 3 hours, then there is a risk of pregnancy. In these cases, emergency contraception can be prescribed. Or when the patient is taking OC pills and there is break of 2 weeks, or patient is late to take the injection DMPA, she is late by 2 weeks. In these cases, emergency contraception can be practiced as a backup method. The protocols which are used in clinical practice are, 2 drugs are used. One is COC, combined oral OC pills, and POP. POP are most effective. In these cases, mini pills are used. And combined OC pills with isoline, ethylene, estradiol, and progestogen pills are used. In all these methods, 2 tablets are given 12 hours apart. First tablet is given within 72 hours of coitus, and the next tablet is given 12 hours after the first tablet. This is the usual protocol for all emergency contraceptives. The pregnancy rate with this is 1.1%. This method, mini pills, can also be used when the patient reports within 120 hours or 5 days of coitus. And it does not have any teratogenic effect, but MTP is indicated in all the pregnancy results. Use by regime of combined hormone pills as an emergency contraception. It is practiced when the patient is consuming oral combined pills. In these cases, the first 2 weeks of the pills, if the patient forgets 2 pills, then first dose of tablet is given within 72 hours of the coitus and the next dose is given after 12 hours. Okay. In the combined oral pill, there are 2 types. One is low dose pill, this one COC, and one high dose pill. High dose means ethylene estradiol is 50 microgram. And low dose ethylene estradiol is 30 microgram or even it can be 25 microgram. When the patient is taking high dose pill, there 2 tablets 12 hours apart are given. When she is consuming low dose pill, if she forgets to take 2 pills in the first 14 days of the cycle, then 4 tablets instead of 2, 4 tablets are prescribed. Then tricolor pills or yellow pill, tricolor pills, when she is taking, if she forgets 2 pills in the first 14 days of the cycle, then same 4 tablets 12 hour apart are taken. The failure rate is 2% or pregnancy rate is 3.2 per 100 women years of use. POP used or mini pill used, the doses we have described, the risk is ectopic pregnancy. It is the most effective method and it can be used as a single dose also. So with the LNG as 0.75 milligram, 2 tablets can be given of 1.50 milligram. Contraindications are liver disease, thromboflebitis, migraine, and there is no teratogenic effect if the pregnancy results, but MTP should be done in all. The mode of action we know, as usual of mini pills, it prevents ovulation, it causes desynchronization of endometrium, it also causes corpus luteal deficiency because she is getting the progestogens throughout. Or with this dose of EC pills, the same will be the mode of action. What are the emergency contraception used when the patient reports within 5 days of coitus? Copper T is one, second one is mifepristone, third one is uliprestol, and fourth one is mini pills. Copper T 380A is a gold standard method. It is effective 0.1%, the best pregnancy rate, the least pregnancy risk. The mifepristone has got anti-progesterone effect. Single dose is required, 50 milligram. 0.9 is the pregnancy rate. Uliprestol, it is selective progesterone receptor modulator. It delays the ovulation. 30 milligram single dose is required. The highest pregnancy rate is reported with uliprestol, 2%. Mini pills we have learned, 1.1% is the risk of pregnancy with this. So these are the different emergency contraceptives which can be used when the patient reports within 5 days from the coitus, from the first coitus. Mifepristone, it is also known as RU486. What is the mode of action? It blocks the progesterone receptors on the endometrium and it causes its sloughing and shedding. It prevents the implantation, does not prevent the fertilization. 50 milligram is the single dose, failure rate we have described. It is 0.9%. The next drug is uliprestol acetate, or it is selective progesterone hormone receptor modulator. It delays the ovulation and it prevents the growth of follicle and endometrium also. Thus, it prevents the implantation of the blastocyst. Contraindications are abnormal liver function test and asthma. Side effects are known, like mood swings and headache. The highest pregnancy rate is reported with uliprestol, it is 2%. Gold standard method of emergency contraception is copper T380A. It is cheap, can be used as late as after 72 hours, but within 5 days of the coitus. Can be continued to use for 5 to 10 years. It prevents implantation, and thus, as it is a gold standard method, can be offered to all women. There is one important drug which is used, which can be used within 24 hours of coitus, cannot be used after that. That is centchromin. It is also known as selective estrogen receptor modulator or meloxifen. The other name is Chaya or Saheli. It is a non-steroidal drug, but it has got potent anti-estrogenic effect. Thus, its effect is on estrogen, on endometrium. It prevents the implantation of ovum. The effectiveness is 99% and 1% pregnancy rate is observed. The peculiarity of this centchromin is it must be used within 24 hours of exposure of unsafe sex. The dose is 60 milligram and the next tablet must be given within 24 hours. So how do you remember it? Should be given within 24 hours of exposure. And the next dose of 60 milligram is repeated within 24 hours. The contraindications are use of antibiotics like tetracycline, amoxicillin. It should be avoided with that. Patient with jaundice and abnormal liver function test, renal disease should not get the centchromin tablets. What about the lactating mothers? Progestin only pills are used in these cases. If she has got lactation amenorrhea, she may not need the emergency contraception at all, because LAM is a method of contraception. Prostaglandins, vaginal pessaries, they have got luteolytic effect, they cause tubal hurry, they prevent implantation of the ovum. But the prostaglandin, GnRH analogs and danazol, they are not approved for the contraception. How do you conceal the lady? Medicine is used within 72 hours after sex to prevent the pregnancy. And explain her that the contraception is effective for that coitus only. Regular contraception practice is vital in these cases. It is not a substitute for regular contraception, because failure rate is more than routine contraceptives. Our intention is to avoid unwanted pregnancy complications and MTP complications. Remember, explain her that it is not effective as abort efficient. Hence, it cannot be used if the patient has missed the period or if pregnancy test is positive. Does not offer any protection against HIV or any infections, sexually transmitted infections. No serious complications are documented and no serious contraindications are reported, because it is a single dose therapy. What is the efficacy in relation to the coitus? It reduces the risk of pregnancy only if the coitus is less than 72 hours prior. If it is not effective if history of coitus more than 72 hours. Apart from that, if more than one sexual contact, but first contact within 72 hours, then only emergency contraception is effective. Failure rate is 1 to 2%. So it is explained the lady that it is not 100% effective. More effective if used within 24 hours of coitus. So as early as the use, the effectiveness is also more. When the next period will be expected in the patient? Usually within 3 weeks, in 98% of cases it occurs. If there is no menstruation, she has to report back. Early periods are expected if the tablets are consumed before ovulation, and late periods if EC pills are consumed after ovulation. What are the side effects? Nausea is observed in 50% of cases, vomiting in 20%. Headache, dizziness are the usual complaints, but menstrual irregularity is a problem in 8% of cases. However, 50% of the women, they return back to normal menstrual period after EC pills consumption. When to start the contraception after EC pills? Barrier methods are the best. OC pills can be started from the last day of EC pills treatment itself. However, it is an underutilized method of pregnancy prevention in India as compared to 100% use in Europe. The reasons are lack of awareness among the seekers and among the healthcare providers, non-availability of registered products of emergency contraception and related services also. Persons who form integral part of welfare services should be trained and they should be updated with the training programs. Participants and service providers both should be aware of this emergency contraception, then only it will be a successful mission to prevent the morbidity and mortality due to unsafe abortions. Thank you for watching this video.